Social media trends on the weekend show. My name is Ina Peters. Glad to be back. I love how Duru said, you know, I was coming to give you guys, yeah, but I mean, tell you the trending stories, but majorly the biggest stories out of the week, because you will agree with me that so many stories trend even in a day. Social media is just where a lot of people just go out to pour out their hats. But we'll begin today's show with the US visa ban. Now, let me just quickly explain this to you. Now, President Trump confirmed this week that the United States plans to expand the travel ban, you know, including adding seven countries. Now, this seven countries is going to add to the initial seven countries, you know, that made the travel ban list. And word has it on the streets that Nigeria is part of that country. Now, it is not certain, you know, if eventually when the final and official declaration or announcement is made, if Nigeria will be on that list, because, you know, there are also speculations that these countries, you know, that are speculated to be on this list, you know, can actually do stuff to or do something or make, you know, changes that might help, you know, their plea. And whether or not, you know, we're on that travel ban list, it doesn't entirely mean that, you know, Nigerians can no longer, you know, travel to the United States. All it means is that, you know, it would be a bit more intense and a bit difficult, you know, protocols and more papers to be signed, you know, for Nigerians to get on that list. I don't know why I keep saying, you know, but let's look at some of the reactions that trailed this news on Twitter. For Temi Tayo, US President Trump is ready to add Nigeria and six other countries on America's visa restriction. The restrictions would apply to immigrants from Nigeria, Belarus, Myanmar, Eritrea, Kyrgyzstan, Tanzania, and Sudan. Nigerians would not be barred totally from entering US. Trump has zero love for Nigeria. I think that emoji stands for like Mugbe or something. All right, moving on to another one. At Mr. Banks on Omishore. So this travel ban thing has been in the works for a while. US gave Nigeria lists of things to do to curb illegal entries and other reciprocity issues, such as cost of visa for US citizens coming to Nigeria and length of visas, also a database of some sort that embassies could check. At Sim Shagaya, the reports of a potential US visa ban on Nigeria represents a sharp wake-up call. I believe the policy will be walked back, but this is terribly embarrassing. We're so much better than this. Maybe these are the sort of things we need to end this celebration of mediocrity. At Truthfully 83, if you are surprised why the United States is branding Nigeria a terrorist state and enforcing travel ban / visa restrictions, Boko Haram kidnap Nigerians and execute them, they kill our soldiers in their thousands, what the government is doing, what with arrested Boko Haram. You know, he's just listing a couple of things. And Rencap Man goes, I'm struggling to understand the possible US travel ban on Tanzania. At least based on visa overstay data, Nigeria a bit more understandable. About 26% of students overstay, but still far from worst ratios in Africa and closer to 11% for business visa. Penalizes the legal majority. I think we have an attachment just showing, if you can move to the next slide. We have an attachment showing, if you look closely, Nigeria expected departures, we have 9.2, and then out of country overstays, we have 258. Now, if you total all of that plus the suspected in-country overstays, you have 2,172. That is, you get 2,430, meaning total overstay rate for Nigerians in America is 26 0.28%, and then suspected in-country overstay is 23.49%. So, you know, I guess he's just backing his claims with figures to show how often Nigerians tend to overstay their welcome. Moving on to another story that took social media this week is the Amotekun issue. Now, the Amotekun security outfit, you know, was formed by governors from the Southwest geopolitical region of the country. Now, this outfit is to help and, you know, assist, you know, the Nigerian police and existing security bodies in the region. When this news broke, there were a lot of controversies surrounding it. We did see some sort of opposition, you know, and we also did see, and we must acknowledge, you know, the support that the security outfit got, especially from people from the West, from that region, saying, yes, the crimes, you know, in our states are too much. So, yes, we want this body. We appreciate this body. And we thank our governors for coming together. Well, as of today, the good news, what we can say is that the Amotekun has received support from the President of the Federal Republic of Nigeria and the Vice President, and even the you know, it just shows, and even, you know, some big political heavyweights. So it just shows that Amotekun is a goal. Literally, it is a goal. Let's look at some of the tweets just showing support for this security outfit. At Harmonies Olajid, at Amotekun, the end of brutality in Yoruba land. Don't evade farm. Don't kidnap our sons and daughters. Don't unleash terror on the people of Yoruba and others who dwell in Yoruba land. Beware of Amotekun. Zero tolerance for criminals. I am Harmony. Adele underscore Olugun. Reason why Amotekun must work out. Currently in the Southwest region, 58,000 police officers to 50 million people, which means one police officer per 862 people. Meanwhile, the UN recommended one police officer per 450 people. Southwest states to recruit over 2,150 for Amotekun. Can you see? And of course, we have the logo there. We see the leopard that is ready. Okay, now an official tweet from the Amotekun page on Twitter. Western Nigerian Security Network, Amotekun, is not a duplication or replacement for the Nigerian Police Force or Army, but has been established to complement the existing security agencies. And we have Omolara 00. Southwest unity, Amotekun is here to stay. Seeing the cordiality amongst them gave me butterflies. Now we can sleep with both eyes closed as insecurity in our land becomes a thing of history. And kudos to Oshibajo for stepping up to handle the whole issue with maturity and diplomacy. At Billy Keys, it's interesting how quickly and neatly the Amotekun impasse was resolved. Our leaders were driven by an urgent issue, security and work to resolve. Wouldn't it be nice if we applied this same urgency to other issues like electricity, environment, health? Yeah, so, you know, thinking about it. Now, you know, there is a saying that what an elder sees sitting down, no matter how high, you know, the child climbs the Iroko tree, he will never see what that elder, you know, saw while sitting down. If this proverb does not remind you of this legend on the screen right now, I don't know what would introduce this next story. Now, the Nollywood legend Pete Edoche is trending. Why is he trending? There was a video, you know, that surfaced online. Now, in that video, he was, you know, he was asked a question, and in the interview, he goes on to say, in the Igbo tradition, the man is not supposed to kneel down to propose to a woman. You know, that what that means is that, you know, the man is handing over power to the woman or so. But you know what? Just take a look at this short clip for yourself. And when after the video, we'll come back and we'll dissect it together and take a look at the reactions.
Onye chonye nwanyi mbana aka na ocholi nu osikpula na alaka obu. Abudu omume anyi. Na omena ani Igbo isikpula na niru nwanyi. Si ani ya nu ebe olu bu ni even even gbasa alu gi. Ichigoli echive enye na aka. Nya buzi onye isi ezinụlọ gị maka na ọ bụ na unu n'anya karibe bụ na nwoke na nwaanyị agbago akwụkwọ na omenala Igbo mgbe nwaanyị ga-eburu mmanya gbuo ikpele n'ana bunye die keribe olo libezie ni ibe ndi ajwa ebe na nekwa na ogo anyi nwoka na obiago onwa anyi yesepu ana bunye die mmanya buru nwoka na esepu anya.
Okay, so now that is the video that has now gone viral. Now we've crossed over to Instagram. So we'll take a look at the comments, you know, that followed this video. I must say a lot of people, you know, did show support for him, you know, telling people there's a lengthier video, so you actually have to watch the entire video to understand. And then there were some others, you know, this is a legend, do not come close to Pete Edoche. I think I'm part of them, but yeah, and others, you know, saying no, this does not make sense, no, this is not supposed to happen. So let's take a look at some of the comments. Flavor Blancho, he is right, who even bring this new down self? This one is asking us. Okay, we'll answer him later. Talk to T underscore me, never forget where you come from, don't allow education take away your brain. He's making sense, even my grandpa told me the same. Ada Kunonso, Igbo culture, elaborated emphasis on that. People need to watch the entire interview, please. Now she is saying, you know, he's not saying it's a general thing. He's saying for the Igbo culture. Okay, and Chi underscore Ka underscore J. Instablog, you people are the problem. This doesn't mean what you interpreted. What he's trying to say is in a wedding ceremony, it is wrong if for a man to kneel in front of a woman with a drink. That means the man is giving her authority over him. Okay. Basically, that means the man is giving the authority over to the lady. Let me break down that comment so you understand it. So yeah, what are your opinions? What do you think, Igbo? So does this mean that, you know, for every Igbo man that has knelt down to propose to, you know, his partner, does this mean that he was handing over his authority or the power to that lady? You know what, you can continue this conversation. I really want to know what you think, so please hit us on our social media platforms at Weekend Show NG, especially on Twitter, and tell us what do you think about this, you know, this comment, this statement by the chief and the Nollywood legend, Pete Edoche. Moving on finally to the last story. I'm sure you saw this, the Dolly Parton challenge. Now, just a few days after celebrating her birthday, Dolly Parton, I think she had no idea what she was doing, or maybe she did, decided to start, you know, this what many have now dubbed the social media challenge, basically putting together a mosaic of four photos representing the profile pictures of four different social media platforms. Now, these platforms are Facebook, Instagram, LinkedIn, and Tinder. Now, I don't know how many Nigerians actually are even on Tinder, but this challenge has been hilarious. I think I will join the challenge eventually if it continues next week. But now let's take a look at some of your faves that decided to join the challenge. All right, so this is the original one she posted. We'll just take a slide of all the pictures. Moving on. Mini Damina, she's from South Africa. We have DJ Copy. See her LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram, and we have Stephanie Coker. So LinkedIn, very serious. Facebook with family. Instagram, you come to slay. And then Tinder is, you know. we have Real Worry Pekin, yes. I like the Tinder slay, dude. I really like it. We have Bolanle, LinkedIn, Instagram, Facebook, Tinder. So basically a representation of what you should. And we have Flying Toby in all four photos, LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram, Tinder. I think, is that all? Oh, of course, MI Abaga. So yeah, some of your faves are definitely jumping on this, so you too should jump on it. You know, it's fun. Just pick out your photos and just put them together and just join the challenge and join the hashtag. The thing with challenges and hashtag is it actually gives your page, you know, more audience, and more people get to see, and they might just check your page out and you might just get more followers. Yeah, you can only get that tip here on The Weekend Show. All right, now I'll be leaving you with the video of the week. Now, you know the popular phrase Mado has been trending from late last year up until this year. Well, our very own MC Sam's skit made it to the show. Basically, it's just, you know, when Mado goes wrong. So you guys know when to use Mado and know when not to use Mado. Thank you so much for hanging in there with me. I hope you enjoyed this segment of the show. My name is Ina Peters. Do follow us on all our social media platforms at Weekend Show NG on Twitter, Facebook, Instagram. You can catch me Ina_Peters on Instagram. I'll be leaving you with a video of the week and I'll see you next week. Thank you. Bye for now.
What do you talk?